In this presentation, we are going to speak about the simulating annealing algorithm, part 1. So, there is an analogy between the energy of a metal in the melting process and the value of the fitness in the problem, the fitment function in the problem. So we got the E nu represents the energy of the new trial solution, and E dT represents the energy of the current solution. We can call this the best so far solution. So it is very important to evaluate this difference in this order, because if you switch the order, you get completely different results. We are going to assume a minimization problem for now. If you are minimizing, we are going downhill. So we are considering the green arrow, the movement to achieve the minimization that you want. So in this case, all the negative differences are improvements, so are downhill movements, and they are going to be accepted. All the uphill movements are not improvements, are deteriorations, and we are going to accept some of these subject to a probabilistic decision, and this is crucial in the simulating annealing algorithm. So here is an example of an algorithm for the simulating annealing. We got here the iteration counter. We got a variable T for the temperature, starts with a maximum temperature, T max. Then we randomly initialize the first solution, or the initial solution, in the search space. And then we got two loops. The first loop is over when the termination criterion is achieved, so for instance reaching the number of iterations. And inside this loop there's another loop which is going to repeat, in this case, T iterations. For each temperature, this loop is going to repeat T iterations, the procedure, okay? Which is initialize a new value, a new solution, and test it. If the solution is an improvement, in this case a downhill movement, we accept it all the times, the new solution as the current solution. Else, if it is not, then it represents an uphill movement in this case, and we are going to just to accept some, depending of a probability value P, and a random value be less, in this case, than this probability value. This probability value is going to depend on the temperature, as we're going to see in the next slide. Okay, in the end of this cycle, the new temperature is evaluated, is decreased, and this is also a very important step in the simulating annealing, because there's different ways to decrease the temperature. This is called the shedding of the temperature, and I'm going to see some examples just in a few moments, okay? So, we are going to see examples of types of probability functions. The probability function in simulating annealing is based on a Boltzmann distribution. So we got here the expression, and you can see that this delta E is inserted in this exponential, and also the temperature is inserted here. So the probability value in each iteration depends both on the delta E, the difference of energy, the difference of fitness, and the temperature value. So you are going to assume, you are going to see what is the type of temperature shadow in a particular case. We are going to consider the delta E constant and positive equals 20. And the initial temperature equals 90, and the final temperature 0. And we got here an example obtained with this law, and it is important to notice two things. First, in this case, the temperature is decreased every 20 iterations, as you can see here, the stepwise decreasing the manner of the temperature. And also it is important to see that the initial value in this case it will be a little higher than 0.4. So in the beginning of the search, there will be almost 50% of chances to a happy solution to be accepted. Okay? If you now approximate this expression by this one, which is the most used and the most common for simulating annealing, let's see in the same conditions as before, what is the probability profile. And we can see here that the probability changes, not only in the profile, but particularly in the initial value. The initial value becomes 0.8. So it is much more, the chances to of an uphill solution to be accepted are higher than before. If you now repeat the same examples with the two probability loss, this one with a smaller differential of the energy in the same conditions, we can see that the profile changes drastically. In this case, it is important to note that the profile is almost flat for the probability almost until the iteration 180. So it is going to be is decreased, but slightly. So this means that if you perform a search in these conditions, it's going to be more or less random with 50% chances almost until the end of the simulation, and this is not good. So if we now use the other law, the approximation, the difference are the type of profile is almost the same, but okay, the initial value is much higher. This indicates that in the beginning of the search, in this case, the search is almost random, and is going to be highly random until late, in this case, until almost 120 iterations. It's going to be decreased the probability, but very with a small slow rate. Okay. If you now repeat these say the prior condition, the prior simulations with another Schedling law. In this case, the new temperature is obtained from the previous temperature using this factor, 0.94. Okay, this weight. And the difference are not only in the profile, as you can see, the profile both in the temperature schedule as in the probability value is much more smoother. So the profile is smoother, and also the initial value in this case is 0.5. Okay, here. And if we repeat with the other law, you can see that in this case also it is much smoother, but the initial probability value is almost 1. Okay? So these all these things are going to affect your performance of your algorithm of simulating annealing. So it is quite important before you run your algorithm to have a good idea about what kind of delta E's you have. Perform some iterations, get an average of this delta E, and then simulate one of these profiles to see if the search is random in the first part or more random in the first part and less random in the and more deterministic in the second part. Okay, and with this slide, with the notes, the class notes, I finish this presentation. Thank you.